the Indonesian against the Spaniard, the former Olympic champion, against a player from Spain who is trying to break down the barrier as far as badminton in his country is concerned. Players being announced over the tannoy. Taufik, such a popular player. Of course, 2004 Olympic champion, up against Pablo Abian here. Abian ranked 34 in the world, Hidayat number 12. A real fighter, the Spaniard. He's going to have to fight here to get the better of his opponent from Indonesia. Change of ends for the players. Well, the winner knows they've got a tough task, but they want to get there, of course, into the last 16. It's Lin Dan, the reigning Olympic champion, who awaits. And of course, lots of people in Indonesia excited at the prospect of the last two Olympic champions meeting. But first of all, Taufik's got to see off Pablo Abian. Both these players have seen off the man who carried the flag for the Czech Republic, that was Peter Kukau. Interesting to see whether the favourite here can wear this man down. Not easy to do, he's a real live wire. Vamos Pablo, says the Spanish flag. Let's go Pablo, who made history with his win over Kukau. He did it in three games, but the first time a player from Spain has won a match at the Olympics. But it's one thing, with all due respect, beating Kukal of the Czech Republic. It's another beating Taufik Hidayat of Indonesia. That'll be it. Years of age. Up against Hidayat now, who's at 30. Just about ready to get underway. Well, the carrot's a big one. Lin Dan awaits in the last 16. Taufik will be desperate to take on his old foe, who of course has got the better of him more times than not. But Taufik knows anything can happen. It's the Olympics. Dreams can come true. He did it in Athens 8 years ago. Just waiting for Lin Nayao of Malaysia to announce the players here.
On my left, Pablo, Abian, Spain.
Now, plenty of support for Pablo Abian here inside Wembley Arena. Well, no doubt Taufik is going to be favourite for this one. But he won't be expecting an easy task against a Spanish player who has made history here then this week with his victory over Peter Kukal of the Czech Republic. First time any Spaniard has won a match at the Olympic Games, and he's off to a quick start here as well. Won't be any panic yet in the Indonesian camp, but I'll be hoping Taufik can get into his stride here. Every point being celebrated so far by Abian, who last year really impressed in the World Championships, beat Mark Ziebler of Germany, who is a fine player. And then when he beat him, he celebrated by tearing his shirt apart. Goodness knows, anyone who knows what he'll do if he beats Taufik here. And he's off to a perfect start, four straight points. What a terrific touch this was. Just guided over the net. A well played point by the former Olympic champion. Off the mark, I think Pablo Abian just hurt his hand a little bit. Fourth Olympic Games for Taufik Hidayat. He's hasn't completely ruled out playing beyond these Olympics, playing in 2013, amidst to being a bit confused about it. Comes here thinking he can still win these Olympics. Reached the quarterfinals in Sydney in 2000, winner in 2004. Lost in the second round in 2008 in Beijing. That's terrific. Should be remembered he was hit by dengue fever in the build-up to the games. Taufik, he came out of hospital. Next day he was training, which obviously was against doctor's orders. Four straight points to the Spaniard, followed by four straight points for the Indonesian player. just out that from Abian. Oh, what a call that is. Just out was just right. Well played. Well, friends, family, and of course just compatriots cheering him on here, and they will be absolutely delighted with that kind of shot here against one of the best players in the world. I mean, Spain is not the badminton nation. Indonesia, of course, a very proud badminton nation. 13 medals they've won in the Olympics at this sport, and the only nation that has won a gold at every Olympics since badminton was introduced in 1992. Of course, there are fears that that run might end this year. He's more than holding his own against Taufik here, Pablo Abian. Well, Taufik's wise enough, experienced enough to know he was in for a battle here this morning at Wembley Arena. But if he didn't, he knows now. Who seems to be particularly worried about reputations, Pablo Abian. In January at the Korean Open, he took Lin Dan to three sets. Didn't quite get the break he wanted with the net cord there. It did drop the right side, but just missed the line. And a nice run of points for him as well. That was another very close call. Another brilliant call. So Pablo Abian has the interval lead against the 2004 Olympic champion here.
Doang dia kan cuma kena gitu di depannya dijagain turunnya ya, jaga poin dulu Fik, fokus terus ya.
Not pretty calm from his coach. Excellent badminton from Abian, who is one of the fittest players around, likes to wear down his opponents with long rallies and great leap. He's not the biggest of players at around 5'7". The Spaniard calls an upset here. Or can Taufik step it up? Convinced that it went in, but it was given out. Seemed to catch the line, didn't it? Of course, there's no way the umpire can overrule unless she is sure. And then the problem is they've now seen it on the big screen here that it hit the line. But she can't overrule it using video referrals. Significant those points can be. I mean, nobody of course wants to make a judge, and we've seen some brilliant calls from the line judges in this match where Abian's had a couple of shots that looked like they might have hit the line and went long, were called long, but given out. 12-all, very tight affair here. Placing the last 16 up for grabs. Lindan, the opponent that waits. Not sure if Lindan's here. He did watch Taufik's first match against Kukau. His previous heights this year so far. Quarters of the All England, Malaysian Open, Australian Open Grand Prix gold. Did get to the semis of the Swiss Open. Taufik, who lost in the second round here last year. Abian getting to the last 16 in the World Championships. Seen much explosion, have we, from Taufik? Shuttle just failing to drift over, but he can really hit them. In fact, he's got the fastest smash recorded in singles competition, Taufik. 305 kilometers an hour. Brilliant. Abian's pumped up here. Sign of desperation trying to play one from around the back there from Taufik. That's better. 14-15. Umpire allowing the players a little mini break here. Towel down. Quick liquid refreshment. Fascinating matchup we've got here now. Abian certainly not overawed by the occasion. And he knows he has the possibility of a major scalp here. Oh, brilliant. Now that is the kind of play that won Taufik a gold medal in Athens. Rock back on his heels and then produce the winning smash. Stepped it up the last few rallies. Great riposte though from Abian. So Taufik ahead. It's been a little while since he's been ahead in this match. Great leap from the Indonesian player. And his fourth and final Olympics. And he doesn't want to go out in a whimper. And now I stepped it up at the end of this first game. The status quo has seemingly been restored here. Abian talking to himself, trying to get himself back on the front foot. Thank you. He's leveled it up, 19-0. Well, well, well. Let call because Taufik had his hand up saying he wasn't ready. Abian served. And interesting time for that to happen at 19-0. And it's game point to Pablo Abian here of Spain. For the Spaniard here, Pablo Abian. Pressure on Taufik Hidayat. Taufik thinking about leaving it, and Abian misses his moment. What an opportunity. Wow. Oh, will he get another chance like that? Just trying to slow things down here, Taufik. He's using his experience. Pablo Abian deciding that. He'll just have to tidy up his towel. Well, in the heat of the battle, 20 points all, first game. Now it's game point to Taufik. Played by Taufik Hidayat. He was in a little bit of a sticky situation there, but he's come through it and he's taken the opening game by 22 points to 20, given a real fright here by Pablo Abian of Spain. First game that was. 23 minutes on court. Abian missing out on a game point.
Jugar un poquito más lejos, un poquito más lejos. Cuando él esté en media pista, jugar un poquito más lejos.
Looks pretty calm, doesn't he, Taufik? I think he's getting what he expected here from this Spanish player. First time they've met, but of course Abian is not an unknown quantity. He's 34 in the world, has been up to number 20 before. Well, I wonder if we're going to get a equally absorbing second game here. Tight start once again. Just wondered after losing that first game whether it would dampen the spirit at all of Pablo Abian, but he's got a spring in his step still. Got a little bit of luck there, but that was a good shot. Yeah, good explosion of power from Taufik. He was ranked 16 in the world when he won gold in Athens. 12 in the world now. Last victory came at the end of 2011 when he won the Indian Open Grand Prix Gold, which is one of the bigger Grand Prix events, not as high as the Super Series events. Abian's victories have come in lesser tournaments than Grand Prix in Poland, Maldives, Sweden and Morocco, winning four events last year. Four times the national champion of Spain. And had a better chance of playing this kind of level of badminton in Spain because of his father, who founded the club in Calatayud, which is where he was from. Well, I think this is the best way forward for Taufik. Abian's game is he likes to be in rallies. He likes to try and wear his opponents down. And well, if Taufik can just swat him away, that's his best chance. Obviously, you've got to find the moment to play the smashes. You have to work the opportunity open, but you just wonder whether that game point 2019 in that first game, whether that was the moment for Abian here, whether the opportunity now has been squandered. Crisis here in the Spanish camp. Abian now the game down, 4 points down in the second. the bit between his teeth now, hasn't he, Taufik Hidayat? Point on the board. It was a good run being put together there by Taufik. Given out, and Abian just misguiding the drift here. A little bit of drift in the court at Wembley. Back out some distance. Recovery shot that from Taufik, wasn't it? Oh, and a brilliant cross-court smash to finish it off as well. And at the interval, Taufik Hidayat now in control, a game up and 11-7 up. That's how to do with the flick serve. Looked a beaten man.
No, aquí no puedes atacar, si no te vuelve loco de un lado para otro. Entonces, relájate, ten paciencia, pues sin paciencia no vamos a ningún lado. ¿De acuerdo? Importante, Pablo. Ponle un poquito de distancia a tu juego en red cuando él saque. ¿Vale? O cuando él te haga un... cuando él esté en centro de la pista.
Pablo Abian find a route back into this match. First point after the interval goes Taufik Hidayat's way. Yeah, nicely guided from Taufik, who has certainly gained his authority on this match ever since saving that game point. He knows how to play these big events, Taufik. A world champion, an Olympic champion. And in his last Olympics, his fourth Olympics, and no disrespect to Pablo Abian, who really has put up a good performance here, but if Taufik is to say goodbye, well, he wants a shot at it, at least, in Dan to face in the last 16. And I'm sure something he would like in in terms of making a statement in his Olympic farewell. And it looks as if he's going to get that now. One thing guaranteed though, Pablo Abian will play every shot with some real meaning. Points now, the gap. The player's put a lot back into the sport in Indonesia. He's got his own sports club. He's funded the renovation of 30 courts in Jakarta, trying to reignite people's love for the sport back home. Would love to play at it in Rio, but knows that he will be too old in 4 years. Well done, Pablo. First point since the interval. Again, Taufik had his hand up as if not ready. Pablo served. And the umpire saying that Taufik Hidayat should be ready. And he should be ready. Now turning into a comprehensive performance from Taufik Hidayat. That was an excellent shot. It's been a morning which has given him a few heart-fluttering moments. But I suppose class is telling in the end here. That's just wide from Pablo Abian. And the finishing line here for Taufik's getting ever so near. The first game was tight, tense, exciting. Second game's been a little bit different. And it's match points, 10 of them for Taufik Hidayat, the 2004 Olympic champion here. Shot in anger from Abian, the Spaniard, who's made his mark this week, whatever. He is the first Spaniard to win a badminton match at the Olympics. Taufik Hidayat will have a shot at Lin Dan at London 2012. The last two Olympic champions will be meeting at Wembley Arena. Comfortable in the end for Taufik against Pablo Abian, who gave him a bit of a fright early on here. had a game point in the first game. But in that second game, it was very comfortable for the Indonesian player. 22-20, 21-11. They were set on collision course. So Taufik winning 22-20, 21-11. It's Lindan next for the Indonesian. That's a mouth-watering prospect, isn't it?